In this video, we're going to learn the concept of energy of simple harmonic oscillator. Have you ever wondered how the energies associated with a pendulum change during its motion? Well, let's understand the answer to this question in this video. Before discussing how the energy of the simple harmonic oscillator changes with its motion, let us learn what is simple harmonic motion. It is the motion of the object in which the restoring force is directly proportional to its displacement, and this restoring force is always opposite to the direction of displacement. F is directly proportional to negative y. Here, F is the restoring force, y is the displacement of the oscillator. A negative sign indicates that the direction of displacement is opposite that of restoring force. The objects that execute simple harmonic motion are called simple harmonic oscillators. The best examples of the objects that execute simple harmonic motion are spring pendulum and simple pendulum. For a simple harmonic oscillator, there is a mean position and two extreme positions on either side. At the mean position, the oscillator moves with maximum speed, and so its kinetic energy is maximum. At the mean position, the displacement of the oscillator is minimum, zero, and the potential energy is minimum, zero. Similarly, at the extreme positions, the displacement is maximum, and so the potential energy is maximum. Also, at these extreme positions, the oscillator momentarily comes to rest and takes its path back, so the kinetic energy at these positions is minimum, zero. At extreme positions, the accelerator of the oscillator is maximum, but its velocity is zero. At the mean position, on the other hand, the acceleration of the oscillator is minimum, but its velocity is maximum. Let us take the example of a simple pendulum, as shown on your screen. Energy at the extreme positions. At the extreme position, the oscillator covers a vertical height of h. So its potential energy is, potential energy extreme is equal to mgh. Here m is the mass of the oscillator and g is the acceleration due to gravity. At the extreme position, the oscillator momentarily comes to rest and reverses its path. So its speed and kinetic energy at this position would be zero. That is, kinetic energy extreme equals zero. Total energy at extreme position of the simple harmonic oscillator is, total energy extreme is equal to mgh. Energy at mean position. At the mean position, the oscillator's vertical height is zero. So its potential energy is, potential energy mean is equal to mg times zero, which is equal to zero. At the mean position, the oscillator moves with greater velocity, and so its kinetic energy is, kinetic energy mean is equal to half mv square. Since the system is under the influence of gravity, it experiences uniform acceleration. So, use the kinematic equation, v final square minus v initial square equals 2g y final minus y initial to find the expression for velocity as a function of height. As the system starts from rest from the reference line, the equation v final square minus v initial square equals 2g times y final minus y initial can be simplified as v squared minus 0 squared, which is equal to 2g times h minus 0, which is v equals the square root of 2gh. Now, substitute the expression v equals the square root of 2gh in kinetic energy mean, which is equal to half mv square. So, kinetic energy mean is equal to half m times square of square root of 2gh, which is equal to mgh. Total energy at the mean position of the simple harmonic oscillator is, total energy mean is equal to zero plus mgh, which is equal to mgh. From this distance, it is understood that the total energy of the simple harmonic oscillator is the same at both the extreme and mean positions. This means the energy is conserved for the simple harmonic oscillator. In other words, the potential energy at the mean position is zero, and it is maximum at the extreme position. Similarly, the kinetic energy at the mean position is maximum, and it is zero at the extreme positions. But the total energy of the simple harmonic oscillator is the same everywhere along its path. In this video, we have learnt what is simple harmonic motion and how the potential and kinetic energies of the simple harmonic oscillator change along its motion. If you wonder how the energies change for a spring mass oscillator, go ahead and use the same concepts discussed in this video to arrive at the results.